Welcome to My Tesla Weekend News Roundup for the week ending November 27th, 2020. Happy Thanksgiving Leftovers Day. Tesla stock had a banner week, starting from Friday's close of $489.61, going up 17%, $84 a share, to close at $574. Comparing that to the NASDAQ for the week, where are we at here? Friday, up 2% on the week. And the S&P up similarly, 2% on the week. Tesla is now ranked number 4 among the companies that have grown the most during the pandemic. You can see number 4 here. It has grown $108.4 billion in market cap. Some non-surprises on here. Amazon, of course they're going to grow. We can't go shopping. Microsoft and Apple, which deal with at-home stuff. A lot of stuff. A lot of not surprises on here. But seeing Tesla at number 4, being one of the few automotive companies to grow, is surprising. Audi's also grown. Interesting. Which of course means Tesla has continued to climb up the total assets by market cap companies. It is now ranked number 9, just behind Warren Buffett's Berkshire Hathaway. And that could change in just a second. This, of course, makes Elon Musk the second richest man alive, overtaking Bill Gates, to be just behind Jeff Bezos. And by just behind, I mean like 30% behind. Bezos has got quite a few of them Amazon bucks kicking around. Everyone can agree Elon Musk is now number 2, and his skeptics agree he's a steaming pile of number 2. But, you know, to hell with them. For anyone curious about Elon's health and well-being, he did a 20-minute interview this week, and you can judge for yourself when his sound begins working. Tesla signs contract with LG Chem for Model Y battery production. They're already using CATL for the standard range, and they're adding LG Chem for Model Y. This diversity of battery sources should ensure the greatest throughput in terms of production. Tesla Model S is the car of choice for Hollywood's rich and famous. As you can see, Bruce Wayne here drives one, as does our good friend Jack from Titanic. Didn't know he survived. But this should come as no surprise. Last year during the Superb Owl, we saw that NFL players love Tesla. No need for Super Bowl ads. Tesla's like an airplane on wheels, says one of the players, who apparently doesn't deserve to have his name mentioned. It drives 90% of my drive to work every day, another player said, whose name is not known, because apparently being a famous football player worthy of interviewing doesn't include asking the player's name. One of the players, known as Dr. Tesla, apparently not on the field, but what is this article? Has a Model X, and yes, he also lets it do most of the driving. One of the players, however, said he didn't like being in a Tesla driving itself. That player, of course, is known as one of the players. Come on, guys. What are you doing, man? What are you doing? Quality journalism. Tesla boosts Model S range again, now beating Lucid Air, which of course hasn't even come on the market yet. When Lucid Air came out with their unveiling, they said they would have a range of 406 miles and be priced competitively with the Model S, being a comparable, pretty four-door sedan. Well, new Model S's shipping apparently have a range of 409 miles. Already whoopin' the as-yet-unreleased Lucid Air. The EPA says the Ford Mustang's Mach-E electric range is a lackluster 211 to 300 miles. Now, while I can agree that 211 is indeed lackluster, 300's fine. It's fine. And for a first offering, it's fantastic. This is extra competition. It's great. It's going to further advance EV adoption. Let's not make too much fun of Ford for making EVs that aren't quite as compelling as Tesla. I mean, let's be honest, none of their cars are really compelling. Tesla Giga Berlin new battery factory can count on a significant subsidy from the government, says Federal Minister Peter Altmaier. Germany is already really at the top in terms of EV production in Europe, with Volkswagen kicking serious butt and the Tesla factory coming online in 2021. Germany's already going to be the EV leader. They're just trying to get more batteries produced in Germany as opposed to in Asia. So it makes sense for Tesla to get some love. Breaking, Tesla Model Y 7-seater, now prepared for delivery. What we haven't seen is any pictures of the back seat. Sandy Monroe from Monroe & Associates had speculated that the third row would have to be installed facing backwards, but Tesla says that's not going to be the case, so it's quite a head-scratcher how they're going to squeeze in two more seats in the back row. My guess would be, for maximum comfort in the third row, one would need to be a small child, a double amputee, or preferably both. China EV top 10 models by volume from January to October of this year. You can see Tesla Model 3, first place with 93,000 deliveries and $3.8 billion in sales. That represents a 27% of units sold and 42% of dollars. This list is far from complete, however. It only lists the top 10 vehicles, and there are many, many more EVs sold in China. Further, the $41,000 average selling price to me is bafflingly low, considering 50 and 60,000 model variants are available in China, and even with the added color, an SR Plus is going to be 38, 39,000, and if there's any amount of FSD take, then we're over 41 just on the base models. So, not sure where these numbers are coming from. Maybe you can help me out in the comments understand this chart. Well, because it's time to measure the sales from the first month of the quarter, Volkswagen ID.3 leapfrogs Tesla and Renault in October European EV sales charts. We see this every quarter. It's exhausting. Oh my gosh, Tesla's cratering. Their sales in Europe are awful. Well, yes, that's because deliveries are always prioritized to local deliveries in the last month of the quarter, meaning no ships are sent to Europe in the last month of the quarter. Thus, very few deliveries can take place in the first month of the quarter. I mean, good for Volkswagen. That's great. But they also have the benefit of pent-up demand as well as pent-up supply. They've been manufacturing the car since January and could only start selling it in Q2 due to fundamental flaws in the software. Oh, and look at that. Two cargo ships unloading Model 3s in Europe right now. One from the US and one from China. With a third ship arriving shortly, this could account for another 10 to 20,000 deliveries in the next 2 to 3 weeks. So, for real, let's stop with these FUD articles. For the first month of every quarter in terms of deliveries, it's exhausting. It's just terrible. This article's a little hard for me to understand on account of not speaking freaky deaky Dutch, but what it says is a PhD team of researchers was able to hack the Model X by uploading firmware onto a key fob, cloning it, and convincing it to unlock the car. You could steal it, basically. All you'd need is about $300 worth of equipment and a team of PhD-level researchers. The team was paid a bug bounty by Tesla, and the cars were patched over the air in August. A 9-second video was released showing some of the details of how the new 4680 cell packs will be built, and they are indeed packed to structure, meaning you can see there the seats are mounted right onto the pack. And there's some exciting footage of the FSD suite in action, how well it identifies all kinds of obstacles. Look at all those people, look at all those vehicles, look at how much thinking the car does while you're busy thinking about one thing. Presumably street fairs, I guess. And in another one, we can see the car driving itself, coming up to a stop sign, and noticing a pedestrian that most humans might not have noticed. You can see it on the arrow there. There's a dude, and he's like, oh, we're not, oh, right, we can't go. Dude in the road. So that's it. Happy Turkey Day and all that, you guys. So happy to have you here. What news did I miss or misunderstand? Leave a comment below. If you haven't already, give it a thumbs up if you appreciate the video, and subscribe if you're not already. It's the only way YouTube knows to share this with others who share the same fascination with this stuff as you and me. Stay tuned, stay juicy, and I'll see you guys soon.